Hello students, today we will start with our second lesson of science 2, that is life processes in living organisms part 1. In this chapter we are going to study about the living organisms and the life processes in very short, and then majorly we are going to study about the living organisms and energy production, right? And we are also going to study about the nutrients and the energy efficiency, means the energy obtained from that nutrients. These two parts we are going to study in short because we have dealt with that in our lower classes also. Energy production and cell division are the two topics which we are going to study majorly in this chapter. Okay, to start with, living organisms and life processes. We know that in living organisms different life processes are there, like respiration, circulation, digestion, excretion, etc., etc. Now all these life processes, they are working under proper control and coordinated manner, right? These organisms are working, as we have studied in physics also, that every part, everything, object to do work requires energy in some or the other manner. So here our body requires energy, which we obtain it from food, right? The source of continuous energy obtained by the body of living organism is the food which it consumes, right? Along with foodstuff, it also requires oxygen, right? It also requires oxygen for the purpose. Oxygen is the main ingredient which helps the conversion of foodstuff into energy. Okay, so different forms of food and all we have studied in our lower classes. So read this first paragraph, it is very simple. Now, to come for the main part, that is our energy production. This part for your class, this observe and can you tell, right? This part, this diagram and everything is not going to be asked in the exam this year. So we will start only directly from the energy production. Okay, here the energy production which is given, it is generalized, it is much related with human being. So we will start with that. Now, as we know that carbohydrates are the main food that we consume daily, right? It becomes, carbohydrates becomes the major part of our diet, right? And we have studied that the energy which we obtained from the food is in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. We have studied this. Now, how this energy is obtained, right? That we are going to study now. Now, we know that the energy obtained in by cellular respiration, right? Cellular respiration, we have studied two types of respirations, right? Breathing and cellular respiration, means external respiration and internal respiration. External respiration is breathing, which we take air in and give out air, means we take carbon oxygen in and we give out carbon dioxide, that is breathing. Excretory respiration, which is carried out through lungs, right? When the oxygen is taken in through lungs, it passes into the blood, and from blood it is taken to the different cells where it is utilized, right? And use of this oxygen for the conversion of the complex food molecules into simpler forms for the production of energy is called as cellular respiration. Now, as we know that this cellular respiration, or respiration, takes place by two methods, right? First is aerobic respiration, which where oxygen is involved, and second is the anaerobic respiration where oxygen is not involved. Now first we are going to start with the respiration where oxygen is involved, right? That is, we are going to study about the aerobic respiration. Now, in aerobic respiration, Aerobic respiration is actually what it is. In your textbook, it is given in three steps: glycolysis, tricarboxylic acid, and electron transfer chain reaction. These are the major three steps. They are given to us in very short. Let's see how. What happens during these steps? In the first step, glucose, that is the form of carbohydrate, right? Glucose, which is there, the aerobic, during aerobic respiration, glucose is oxidized, right? Main step is what? Glucose is oxidized. Further, oxidization of glucose or conversion of glucose into pyruvic acid in the cytoplasm, it takes place in cytoplasm, is called as glycolysis, breaking down of glucose molecule. Glyco, that is glucose, lysis, breakdown, right? Due to oxidation, right? The oxygen which we have inhaled, right? So during this process, at first, the first step is conversion of glucose into pyruvic acid. Here, ATP molecules are formed, NADH2 molecules are formed, and H2O molecules are formed. What is this NADH2? Now, NADH2 is nicotinamide. Separate it like that. Nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, right? Nicotinamide NAD and H2O, along with this nucleotide, hydrogen is there. So H2 comes. So nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide is formed here. So during glycolysis, glycolysis, pyruvic acid, ATP molecules, NADH2 and H2O molecules are formed, right? Now from this pyruvic acid in the cytoplasm only is converted further into acetyl coenzyme. It is a coenzyme, right? Acetyl coenzyme. Again, two molecules of NADH2 and H2O are formed. Here NADH2 is formed, water is also formed. Again, only pyruvic acid over here is converted into acetyl coenzyme, and during this formation of acetyl coenzyme, again NADH2 and water molecules are formed. Now this is the first step of glycolysis, right? This is the first step of cellular respiration, that is glycolysis. Now this acetyl coenzyme, it enters into the mitochondria. Acetyl coenzyme enters into the mitochondria. And in this mitochondria, the cyclic chain reactions occur, right? Different chain reactions occur. It is not a single process. Many reactions that they are not explained to us that much deeply. Only in short they have explained us, right? So cyclic chain reactions occur. And they all togetherly are called as tricarboxylic acid cycle. They togetherly are called as tricarboxylic acid cycle. This is the second step. Now in this, what happens? From the acetyl coenzyme, the acetyl part is completely oxidized, right? Acetyl part is completely oxidized during this second step. And here again, carbon dioxide, water, molecules of NADH2, and along with that FADH2 is formed. What is this FADH2? FADH2 is flavin adenine dinucleotide, right? This full forms you have to remember. Both these enzymes are formed in the cells and used in cellular respiration. Okay. This is the second step where acetyl part only gets completely oxidized. Okay. Now the third step, which also takes place in mitochondria. Third step also takes place in mitochondria. It is called as electron transfer chain. Electrons are transferred here, and it is also a chain reaction. One reaction is related to other. It is a very long chain, right? It is a chain of reactions coming step by step, one after other. So electron transfer chain reaction. Now in this, the molecules which are formed in the second step, NADH2 and FADH2, are from them the ATP molecules are released, right? NADH2 gives 3 molecules of ATP, and FADH2 gives 2 molecules of ATP along with water. Here also water is formed, right? Thus, all the glucose or these molecules which you have obtained from glucose are converted into ATP, that is in the stored form of energy, right? So thus we say that during cellular respiration glucose molecule is completely oxidized to obtain or to give carbon dioxide, water and ATP molecules. How are these ATP molecules is been done in the 3 steps, right? Now this ATP molecule is further converted into ADP molecules, which is the actual energy content. Now what is this, how is this conversion is given here in your textbook in a reaction manner, right? See, this adenosine triphosphate ATP, right? Adenosine, ribose sugar and phosphorus. Now one of the phosphate bond is removed from that, right? And energy during this breaking of this phosphorus bondings, the lot of energy is released, right? And that energy is used in the body. So whenever we want energy, more energy, this ATP molecule, from that the phosphate bond is released, is removed, and during the separation the energy is released and this organic phosphate gets converted into inorganic phosphate. This is how the energy is obtained by the body. But during some cases what happens, that carbon dioxide, carbohydrates in the body become insufficient. In such conditions, why they may happen, due to hunger or due to fasting, long fasting and all, right? In such cases the energy is also obtained from lipids and proteins. Lipids are converted into fatty acids while proteins are converted into amino acids, and these fatty acids or amino acids, they are converted further into acetyl. Instead of glucose, fatty acids and amino acids produce acetyl coenzyme, which is further oxidized to produce energy. This process is called as Krebs cycle. It also takes in mitochondria. Okay, so this is how energy is obtained in the body. Now further we will see anaerobic respiration. This chart is given in your textbook, right? These 2 charts are given. This is for aerobic respiration, this is for anaerobic respiration. But you have to do your own chart. This chart is, I think it is incomplete, or it is very very short. So as I have made this points, you make them in the form of chart. This is your today's homework, right? Now energy production in microorganisms through anaerobic respiration, this part we will do now. Now what happens here, some organisms, they may not require oxygen or they may not get oxygen, like bacteria, right? Without the help of bacteria, without the help of oxygen, they have to produce energy in them, which is required for their body. So what they do, they carry out anaerobic respiration, right? Anaerobic respiration. Now during this anaerobic respiration, glycolysis and fermentation, right, takes place. First, glycolysis means formation of pyruvic acid is going to take place. Further, this pyruvic acid is fermented, right, to produce energy. So glucose, here during anaerobic respiration, glucose is incompletely oxidized, and that's why less amount of energy compared to cellular energy is obtained, right? Pyruvic acid produced through glycolysis is converted into other organic acids or alcohols with the help of enzymes, right? And this process is called as fermentation. In some higher plants also or animals, aerobic respiration is carried out, but sometimes they carry out anaerobic respiration instead of aerobic respiration. When this thing happens, if there is depletion in oxygen level in them, right? Depletion in oxygen level. If oxygen is not obtained by the organisms, then they may go for anaerobic respiration also. Example they are given. Seeds perform anaerobic respiration if the soil is submerged under water during germination. Similarly, second example, our muscle cells also perform anaerobic respiration while performing exercise. We get no pain in them, right? So due to this, less amount of during exercise, lot of exercise, rigorous exercise, less amount of energy is produced in our body and lactic acid accumulates due to which we feel tired after doing exercise or doing a lot of exhausting work, right? Lot of muscular work when done, then we get tired. This tiredness is because of the formation of lactic acid due to the anaerobic respiration which is carried out in our body. So this is how the energy production is carried, energy is produced in the living organisms. Okay, thank you.